So today's topic is conversion of galvanometer to ammeter. So first we'll learn what is the need to convert galvanometer to ammeter, because both the devices measure current only. So what is the need to convert and how to convert, and then how to solve numerical. Okay, so let's first discuss why. So a galvanometer can detect only small values of current. You can see this is a galvanometer, and on this meter it's in microampere. So the galvanometer can only measure current in microamperes. It means in the range of 10 to power minus 6 ampere. To measure large current, it is converted into an ammeter. And if you see, this figure is of ammeter. So here you can see it is written only A, not micro A or milli A. So this is 10 ampere, 20 ampere, 30 ampere. So to measure large amount of current, a galvanometer is converted to ammeter. Okay, so this logic you have to remember even for your practical exams and Viva also. Okay, now how to convert. So galvanometer can be converted into an ammeter by connecting a low resistance. Please remember, low resistance called as shunt resistance in parallel to the galvanometer. Let's see how. Suppose we have a galvanometer. So G is also resistance of galvanometer, and IG is full scale deflection current. It means the galvanometer can measure maximum IG. So galvanometer cannot measure current more than IG. So how to measure current I with the help of this galvanometer? So what we'll do is, we will connect a small resistance RS in parallel with the galvanometer. Suppose the current I is coming, so IG will go in galvanometer. So we'll choose the value of R such that IG will go in the galvanometer and the remaining I minus IG will go in the shunt resistance. Now if we'll see, both this resistance are connected in parallel, and in parallel value of potential difference is equal. So across this shunt resistance, the potential will be IR, so I minus IG into RS, and across this galvanometer, the potential difference will be IG into G IR. So value of shunt resistance will be IG into G divided by I minus IG. But please remember, whenever you get question in exam like how will you convert this galvanometer into an ammeter, please draw the diagram. Diagrams are the most important one. You have to write down whether you are connecting the resistance in parallel or series and what is the value of this resistance. And also please remember, in an ammeter, the shunt resistance is connected in parallel with the galvanometer, but ammeter is connected in series in an electric circuit. So please remember this point. Okay, now let's solve one numerical. So this numerical is from our NCRT only, question number 4.28. So a galvanometer coil has a resistance of 15 ohm. So G is 15 ohm. And the meter shows full scale deflection for a current of 4 milliampere. So IG is basically 4 milliampere, that is 0.004 ampere. How will you convert the meter into an ammeter of range 0 to 6 ampere? So I have to measure 6 ampere. So the value of shunt will be IG into G divided by I minus IG. So if you put all the values and we'll see, 0.004 is much lesser than 6. So if you ignore this thing, the answer will be 0.01 ohm. So this is basically how we have converted the galvanometer to an ammeter. Now what you will do is, I'm sending you a PDF with this slide, with this video. So all the questions of galvanometer to ammeter conversion, please try them. And if you have any doubt, please let me know. Okay.